So you've decided to buy a house, now you have to figure out where you're actually going to make a purchase. In this video, we're going to talk about all the things to consider when you're picking a specific area. Hey everyone, Mariah Taliaferro with Premier Sotheby's. I'm an agent here in gorgeous Sarasota, and I love putting together these videos so they can be helpful for you in your buying and selling process. So do tune into our channel. We have a lot of videos about what it's like to live here, work here, play here, and do all the amazing things that Sarasota has to offer. Do me a favor though, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and post your comments below, whether you like it, you don't like it, or you have any questions or further comments about the topics that are being discussed. So let's talk about what the process should really go like when you're looking to move to an area. So hopefully if you are isolated, like you wanna move to a specific city. So let's take Sarasota, for example. You've decided you wanna move here. Now you have to pick out which community to focus on. And the reason you wanna do this is, number one, you don't wanna waste your time. You don't wanna waste the agent's time that you're working with. And you also need to be aware of how the market conditions are in the area that you're making a purchase. So right now, things are flying off the shelf. So the more equipped you are with kind of more of a narrowed criteria, the better off your search and your experience is going to be. So definitely narrow the focus on particular neighborhoods or just designated areas. But let's talk about what you actually need to think about in order to get there. So first off, decide, what is the purpose of this purchase? Are you buying this as a second home, a primary residence, or as an investment? If you're looking to purchase this as an investment property, you're gonna have very different criteria than if you're purchasing it as a second home that you're gonna live in. So for instance, let's say you are buying this as an investment. You need to determine, is this a long-term investment that you're just kind of hold and hope for like 10, 20 years down the road that it's going to appreciate in value? Or are you looking to do this as a short-term or long-term rental? So really figuring that out will really help you determine what area of town you want to be in. For instance, if you want to be in like more of an Airbnb situation, you need to make sure you're in the areas that are the most desirable for the Airbnb clientele. So like the Keys, really close to the beach or close to downtown. But you also need to be mindful that each of those areas have different county and city restrictions. So you might want to be able to be like right downtown to do an Airbnb situation, but you can't because the city and county restrictions there are a 1 month minimum. Whereas if you're like in Siesta Key, you can rent your property for a week, but it's also dependent on the HOA. So a lot of things to think about. That's why you need to get really, really clear about what it is that you want, so that it can make your life easier and also your agent's life easier. So if you're buying this now as a full-time or part-time residence, really think about, what is your life going to be like outside of your home? So are you gonna be wanting to be close to golf or tennis, or are you a big beach goer and you really don't wanna commute 25 minutes each time? Really think about that. And also think about, what are the extracurricular activities that your family is involved in, like swimming or any hobbies that they have. If you have children, you wanna be very mindful of the type of school that you want to be in. I've done many videos about the different schools here in Sarasota, and we have a great school system. Most of our schools are top rated, but some people are particular and they wanna have certain programs like a visual and performing arts or lacrosse. So definitely go through your criteria, list out your must-haves so you can really isolate an area based on that. Also list out how far you're willing to commute, like 15 minutes, 10 minutes, 5 minutes. I live in a little triangle. I go from my house to my office and it's like 3 minutes away, and that's my must-have. So everybody's different, but be sure to list those out so you can isolate the area based on that criteria. Price, of course, is a big consideration, and it's happening all the time. People are getting priced out of certain neighborhoods that they would really love to be in. So it's the sad reality, but it is reality, especially in the market that we're in. You're moving to a very desirable area, and with everybody wanting to move down here and inventory being very lacking, that naturally brings price up. So even though I keep telling you to have your preferences in place, You also need to be really realistic about how likely it is for you to get all those preferences for your price range. So that'll be definitely a conversation that you should have with your agent, and make sure you have an agent that's going to be honest with you about it. Otherwise, you're going to waste a lot of time and be very, very disappointed. So there's really a lot to consider when you're picking out a specific area, and your lifestyle might change. You're going to move to Florida. It's a totally different environment. You may find that you're going to start different activities that you never did before, like gardening or paddleboarding or something. So definitely keep an open mind when you move down here, and but also be flexible. So have your preferences, be flexible, be willing to explore different things, and kind of come at this whole search process with a blank slate in some ways, with some idea of what you want to do, so you can kind of guide yourself and guide your agent to the type of purchaser and person you are in general. But I would have an open mind, because you may find that Sarasota is filled with amazing things as it is, and you're going to pick up various hobbies. But you also might find that you can't get everything that you want in the price that you're looking for. Or maybe you can, I don't know. So anyway, that's my two cents on the whole matter. If you have any questions, definitely post your comments below or reach out to me directly. But do leave your feedback. I'd love to know what you think about these videos. And if you have any suggestions on other content, definitely let me know.